a child who was killed by the police. The police judge has now said, yep, case can actually move forward. Let's put up her picture full mass. We covered this on day one. This is an update to a story that we covered last year. A county court judge rejected the request to dismiss manslaughter charges against three cops charged in the killing of that 8-year-old child. That 8-year-old child was a bystander. Former Sharon officers Brian Devaney, Patrick Dolan, and Devon Smith are facing manslaughter, involuntary manslaughter, and reckless endangerment charges, and they should. However, their lawyers have argued the officer should only be charged with misdemeanor reckless endangerment offenses because they were responding to a shootout between two teenagers who were initially charged for the murder of the girl. Fanta Bility is her name. But a judge rejected the request on Monday. If the defense lawyers lose the appeal, the officers will have to fight the charges in trial and appeal, however, would delay that trial. Now, what they did was horrific. What they did was disregard the lives of those around them, and it ended up killing a baby girl. Initially, the teenagers who did not shoot her were charged with her murder. Now, follow the logic here. So the police, they say, oh, well, wait a minute. You all put her in danger because you all were shooting. And because of that, it created a cause and effect dynamic that led to the death of this child. So we're going to charge you with murder, even though your bullets did not hit this child, even though you had nothing to do with the actual death of the child. Bullets did not hit the child from a teenager's gun. The bullets came from the cops because of their reckless disregard for life. By the way, if anyone else would have been involved in this, trying to stop the other teens who are involved, and they shot a child, well, they would be arrested for reckless endangerment, involuntary manslaughter. There's more. Fanta's family, they have said as of Monday, they were satisfied with the court's decision. I am a little happy today, Fanta's mother, Tina Croma said, told reporters this. Reports show, I'm gonna go back to the background, reports show that 100 to 200 people, think about the size of this, right? 100 to 200 people were leaving a high school football game last August in the Philadelphia suburb when officers decided to open fire in a crowd, reckless endangerment already established. An argument between Angelo Ford, who's 16, and Hussein Strand, 18, escalated into gunfire. And the officers shot 25 times at a Chevrolet Impala they believed was involved. Fanta, the child, and four other people were shot in the crossfire. The girl died because her gunshot was in her chest. The DA announced the charges against the officers in January, concluding without a reasonable doubt that the gunfire that killed the girl was from the police. A grand jury recommended charges. Those are citizens in that community. The citizens recommended charges for the officers who were also fired from the department for violating protocol. All three men are out on bail. Once again, protections that exist for cops don't exist for anybody else. Those cops should have been arrested on day one. Initially, who got arrested for the murder of the child? People that didn't do it until forensics verified that the police did it. All of a sudden, the police, who are wrong, even their defense attorney argued, yes, our clients are all wrong. Reckless endangerment, misdemeanor count. No, the grand jury said felony. Those are citizens of the community who had evidence presented to them, and they were appalled at how reckless these cops decided to act. There's a child who's dead, and now the wheels of justice, because of the judicial decision, will move in the right direction. We're going to continue to follow this story as it goes to trial. David, did the judge get this right?
Yeah, I'm just glad that the judge upheld the charges, that the initial cover up was proven to be a cover up. And I think the only thing that disappoints me a little bit is I think in Philadelphia and in Pennsylvania, you don't have to go to a grand jury if you're a local prosecutor. But a lot of times in police cases, they will. So it seems like it's the way of the district attorney, which sometimes has to work with the police, and they can say, oh, this wasn't me, this was a grand jury. That's not exactly a profile in courage. And I wish that the district attorney had shown the courage to say, you know what, this is so clear cut, we don't need a grand jury. We know the forensics show that this was a police bullet that killed her. So a little disappointed there, but I think in the end, the outcome is the right one.